Welcome to Mongoose channel. In previous videos, we demonstrated how to use Mongoose Wizard to connect to MQTT server and implement remote device control and firmware updates. Today, I'll show you how to enable TLS for MQTT connections. I will be using an STM32 development board. Visit mongoose.ws and open Mongoose Wizard. Start a new project. Select the target directory where the generated project will be stored. Choose the target architecture, Nucleo-F756ZG, but you can use any other board, the procedure will be identical. We could use Zephyr or Cube as the build environment, but let's stick with the bare metal makefile to keep things quick and simple. Choose a blank dashboard, click Next, and click Finish. On the Settings tab, disable the web UI and HTTP, as they are not needed, and enable MQTT. By default, the HiveMQ public MQTT server is used. Mongoose's built-in TLS stack implements the modern TLS 1.3 protocol, whereas the HiveMQ server uses TLS 1.2. So let's switch to another public broker that supports TLS 1.3. For example, testmosquito.org. For now, we'll use plain MQTT, and later we'll enable TLS. Click Generate. The wizard creates a bare metal project in your output directory. Start a serial console. Run make build flash to build and flash the binary. Debug logs show that we have successfully connected to the MQTT server. Open the mongoose glue.c file, which contains the default MQTT implementation that we can override. There are instructions in the comments. Let's read them. This implementation creates a very simple MQTT client that subscribes to the Rx topic, waits for messages on that topic, and echoes the received message back to the TX topic. Copy the implementation to main.c, rename the glue prefix to my, and configure Mongoose to use our MQTT functions instead of the default ones. Rebuild and reflash. Make sure our application still works. Let's test with an MQTT client. Search for an online MQTT client and choose one provided by EMQX. Web clients cannot use MQTT directly. Instead, they use MQTT over WebSocket. Use the testmosquito.org broker with port 8081, the secure WebSocket port. Connect and subscribe to device 1/hash. Publish a message to device 1/Rx and observe the response. Our firmware works as expected. Hear how it works now. The device-to-server connection uses plain text MQTT, while the online MQTT client uses a secure TLS. Now, let's enable TLS on the device side. Go back to the wizard and change the URL from MQTT port 1883 to MQTTS port 8883. In the project settings, choose Integrate to existing project, then click Generate. Now, Wizard MQTT URL uses MQTTS, and we enter the TLS branch of the connection setup. It uses TLS CA, which is currently empty. We need to set TLS CA to the proper certificate used by the testmosquito.org server. If you're not familiar with these terms, see our video on TLS fundamentals. There are multiple ways to fetch the CA certificate. An easy method suggested in the comment is to use the mongoose.ws/TLS helper page. Enter testmosquito.org 8883, click Get CA Certificate, then click Show as C++ constant, and copy that value into main.c. Now, when testmosquito.org sends us its certificate during the TLS handshake, our firmware can properly verify it using the CA certificate, and the TLS connection will be established successfully. Rebuild and refresh the firmware. Notice the logs. Our device now uses TLS. Send another message from the test client and observe the response. This is how you can set up secure MQTT over TLS. Hit like and subscribe if you found this video useful. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.